Oh, I'm sorry. You raised some very good points, and what you've done is you've actually challenged us to come up with. So we need to hear more of what you're talking about, more of what you think is going to help. I'm a little bit older than you are. I'm not quite sure where we're going, but we need to continue this dialogue with the city as to what you would think would be most advantageous for us to do. Darlene has been a very strong proponent of those types of things, and maybe you can kind of be a little bit of a liaison as far as those types of things that you think would be helpful as you just alluded to. So we're going to put that back on you for a little bit. We need to let us know what we should be doing, what we could be doing to possibly help.
Well, just to make my, to say who I am, I'm Darlene Duggins Magdalinsky, and I reside in Churchville, Pennsylvania. Just to answer your quick question with that, Carmen had brought up some important points about us having more things in each area. I came on board with Building Bridges and put together a neighborhood enrichment team guideline that has yet to be put into effect. That is something that I know will be effective. It was a very tedious job to sit down at home and to put that neighborhood enrichment team guideline together. I know that it will be effective. So I can go into more details with you guys offline if you want, but it's definitely an effective plan as long as we put it together. I've actually, I was hired as the program coordinator for the Food and Fund program this summer. And I actually targeted Sherman Hills intentionally because I knew that was a bad area. When we had our kickoff, that park, Cole Street Park, was intentionally selected. They asked me, where do you want the kickoff? Where do you want to have that? I said, I wanted that Cole Street Park. I knew we needed to have it there for a lot of reasons, because I know that's where our problem area was at. But again, we can talk more offline about what we need to do as a community, as leaders, so that we can better our community. But more than anything, I have some questions, and it's going to address a lot of the issues that what they talked about is going to also talk about, and I think it's going to go into more details where you guys will probably answer some questions on what you were talking about. Now, again, I have some questions, so maybe, Greg, maybe you guys can jot this down, because I have more questions, and I'm going to relay back to some press releases. The one question I have is, how many police officers are dedicated to this particular area, which is Sherman Hills? That's what one of the things I want to know. The second one is, do we have a gang task force? And if so, why have they not taken this issue? Why have they not tackled this issue with the task force, which Sherman Hills task force? You know what I'm saying? I understand that there's a lot of people here, or some people here, that's on the panel of the task force. What are the city's intentions to address the high crime rate besides Sherman Hills? Because at the end of the day, the Sherman Hills task force, at the end of the day, it is not the Sherman Hills task force responsibility to tackle that issue. It is the city's responsibility to tackle the issue. I feel that the owners of Sherman Hills have not shown any accountability towards their commitment. Providing substantial cameras in the complex and delivered the guard booth as promised. Bottom line, that was a part of the HUD requirements that they came here to City Council based on a press release and made a promise to you guys that this is what they were going to deliver. And instead of delivering, it shouldn't be something that is, oh, we can't make them do it. It was something that was required. And I'm just reading from the press release, which I have the press release here, or I can give you a copy of it, which my buddy back here has. This is not something that I'm making up. They get a walkthrough, and when Congressman Cartwright get that walkthrough, and George Brown, you did the walkthrough, you guys recommended. It shouldn't have been a recommendation. It should have been a mandation. All right. You guys saw that. They did not have the home guard. They spent $77,000. $1,000 on 25 air conditioners. I just want to know, where did they get these air conditioners at for $77,000? What they should have did was took that $77,000 and got on guard. That's what they should have done.
Amen.
They get air conditioners when that's not what the issue was. They fixing
the
outside. That's not what the issue was. They're putting up two cameras. After they even put up the two cameras, we had still have had killings. You had the owner that clearly said, after the fact, after they promised that they were going to put up these cameras, during when he did the walkthrough, he said to you guys, well, he went back and he said, okay, well, I don't think that we would need any guards if we got cameras. Well, it's clear that the cameras is not working because we still are having killings. Mm-hmm. And the bottom line is you guys, I felt, should have come back and said, listen, that wasn't part of the agreement.
Amen.
You had a guy there who said, I am a formerly drug addict. When he made a reference to everyone and said, when he made a reference to the team and said, and I know I got 3 minutes, but please let me finish. When he said that, when the guy referred and he said, I'm a formerly addict and I think that we need to arm guards, you shouldn't have ignored that. I want to say this. We have this mom here. This is the mom here that just lost her son. I don't know if you guys know that. We have Miss Golden here, who her grandson is Tiger. And we have, I just want to say thank you guys so much for just coming and showing up. I asked them for, I want standing room, and I got standing room.
Amen.
I'm gonna, let me say this, please. Okay, Bill, okay. Okay. Bill, what's important is, if we want to be effective as a team, as a community, how can we be effective? The way how we can be effective, we will never be effective, first of all, is I know based on the people that we have on the team of the task force, every last one of them are politicians. Mm-hmm. They don't have any experience. We need to bring people on the team that has experience on how to address these issues we are facing in this community. Can you please help me and answer some of these questions?
I'm just overwhelmed by what I'm seeing and hearing here. I think everyone here is. Mr. Brown and I, and I know he wants to talk about our conversations with Sherman Hill, but there's so much passion here and so much belief and desire here that we could go on for hours. And maybe what we need to do, Darlene, is have a forum just specifically addressing what we're talking about here.
Exactly.
We certainly have to be here. It can be anywhere. For somebody like yourself and everyone who wants to, and we all want the same thing.
Yes.
We all want to live in a safe,
yes,
healthy community where violence is very infrequent. We're not seeing that. So there are solutions that everyone here wants to bring up. And I'm advocating that we just continue this dialogue in a forum designed specifically to address just that. Aside from everything else, whether it's weeds growing someplace or some other problems the city might have. So I think we just need to continue what we've started, not what we've started, what you have started here, and everyone here this evening, and we can move forward from that. And together, we can make a difference. Let's keep this dialogue going, let's communicate back and forth.
Darlene, if I could say a few things. First of all, not everyone on that task force is a politician. Mr. Felton's not a politician. Mr. Felton's not a politician. Mr. Jerome's not a politician. But there are several people that are not politicians on that.
What is the experience, though? At the end of the day, in all due respect to you, Ron, I'm saying, what is anyone on that task force? I personally feel that a lot of people that's on that task force, first of all, is only two women, and the rest are males. We need some diversity, and not speaking from just from a culture standpoint, but we need some ordinary citizens that is experiencing this. We need to listen to the people that is, how about we go into some of these people that is in Sherman Hills and getting their input and listening to them, because these are the people that is experiencing this.
Mr.
Brown,
let me just finish. If you don't mind, just a couple of things. The task force members, including myself, we were asked to do that. The reason why I joined it was hoping that we could help the situation of Sherman Hills by seeing what's going on and offering our assistance. You know, I'm sure that's why everybody else wanted it too. Secondly, Well, Mr. Barrett and I actually took a tour before the task force, and we talked to the gentleman that's running Sherman Hills. Okay, we sat with him. We looked at a drawing of the property, and that was about 2 weeks before we took the tour. We then took the tour, and we did the part, right, in addition to other people. We sat and we talked to residents. We talked to people that were living there that told us about their concerns, that told us about what was going on and so forth. The agreement that was made with the prior ownership, I can't tell you that is mandatory for the new ownership. Okay? Do we want to see guards there at night?
The agreement that I talked about. Okay.
Do we want to see armed guards? Do I want to see guards there at night? Yes. Okay? I do want to see guards there at night. I can't tell you, Darlene, or anyone else in this room, that we have the authority to mandate that, because that agreement was prior ownership. I think it's warranted. The people that were sitting there talking to us told us it was needed. I would like to see that, but Mr. Heavy, maybe you can help out. I don't think we have the authority.
So they're just talking points?
No. Now, when I said that this agreement was made, you guys, this agreement was not made with, I have the proof here.
We're not going to do it. We're not going to go back and forth. Okay. We all agree that something needs to be done there.
Yes.
Tear it down. Tear it down.
Let's continue the dialogue, not only on Sherman Hill, but violence in Wilkes-Barre.
Go ahead.